Hi YouTube. Welcome back to another episode of Citizen Tech Talk. Guys, just wanted to introduce you to the kind of the dual phase episode today. Early Halloween intro, and I hope you enjoyed that and had a bit of a giggle. Guys, we're actually talking about something a bit more serious later on in the video after the Halloween element of the episode. More importantly, it's to kind of give you guys finally a visual insight into how Redditors think, how they behave, what goes through their head. Because, like, you know, I've said a million times before, sociopath this, psychopath that, you know, deranged mental case this, etc. that, right? Troublesome kids, bad upbringings, etc. So what I've done is I've actually just tried to encapsulate that into video imagery. Yes, there's some satire in there, but there's obviously quite a large element of truth to marry up with it. So don't take all the grain of salt and just think a little bit outside the box and just kind of put two and two together. I know you guys are more than capable of that. Well, at least you non-Redditors there. Okay, Redditors. I'm dumping the shitbag on you today. Welcome to the episode. Everything that's scary, that goes bump in the night. Every time you hear a whisper, a chilling little fright. Every time you look and look out the door, you swear you saw something, but it's not there anymore. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Halloween. Time of witches, gargoyles, and ghouls. The witching hour, it seems. Tonight you'll be sharing with me a special, special story about the Redditors and how very, very gory their story. The Redditor, the mind, the craziness, the demonic nature of the beast shall be seen in images that may concern some at the very least in the time between now and when we get really serious. Please enjoy a visualization of the Redditors, mischievous. The mind of the Redditor, the sick, twisted beast. You shall now see how they see us at least. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to CTT's early edition Halloween special. Enjoy.
Open your eyes, look up to the sky. rise and see. I'm just a poor boy, I need no sympathy. 'Cause I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low. Any way the wind blows doesn't really matter to me.
Loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, spared in his life from this
monstrosity. No, no, no.
Easy come, easy go. Will you let me go?
Ma, na, ma, na.
Let me throw.
Ooh, ma, na, ma, na.
They will not let you throw.
Let me blow.
Ma, na, ma, na.
They will not let you blow.
Let me jump.
Do not like your jokes.
Let me jump.
Do not like your jokes.
Let me jump.
No, 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 no!
For Nigiri, for Nigiri!
Mamma mia, let me go!
Does anyone know if there is a part for me? For me? For me?
So they tell us this video's going too far!
Creatures of the night, the initiation held within this temple on this finest and most forsaken evening, with all of its rituals, its macabre, its dance with the spirits of darkness, has now so boldly come to thrust itself upon us. For tonight's events are here to serve us as a means and mode of transformation, so that we may step into the deeper, darker realms of utter abyss. Yes, tonight is our grand ceremony. And this is our ultimate retreat. As for now, this temple shall become our hellbound labyrinth into other worlds, other dimensions. So come ye all dead, undead, and unforgiven. Come and enter here and experience the strange and horrifying mysteries of the unknown. Yes, my wretched friends, welcome to the initiation, and welcome to the Temple of the Fool.
You see, in every job that must be done, there is an element of fun. You find the fun, and snap! The job's a game. And every task you undertake becomes a piece of cake, a lark, a spree. It's very clear to see that a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way. For a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down, the medicine go down, medicine go down. Just a spoonful of sugar helps the medicine go down in a most delightful way.
A spoonful of bleach helps the medicine go down, Redditors! Right, so guys, the real purpose of this part of the video is to kind of hit the ground running, hit it hard, and cut through the crap. The Star Citizen Refund Reddit has only just been taken over by Russian scammers, as pretty much we can tell, and the information I've been provided in great detail by, once again, an info dropper, one of my original and still continuing subscribers, who has decided to basically have enough himself and also provide me with this pretty damaging information. Now, guys, I've shown you how Agony Arts continued to carry on, reporting me on Discord. Like, really? Do you think I care? Like, Reddit, do you think I care? No, I really don't. Anyway, that brings me to this point, guys, quickly. We now have Star Citizen Facts Reddit up. I'll have the link in the description below for you. And also, the Cyberpunk 2077 Shitshow Reddit. So I'll put that link in there for you as well. I do have a link up in there from Upper Echelon Gaming, and I'd really like you to watch his video because he's touching on something very early on that I was very concerned about myself, but obviously had my reservations. The game's not out yet, you know, proof, facts, and evidence stuff. But I think he's really, really, really come across a very, very valid point and a really strong point of discussion that I think we should all start having. So please check out both the Reddits. The links will be in the descriptions below. But guys, you can get in there and not have to worry about these idiot fools that I'm going to be dispatching today in the form of Agony Aunt and all the others I've already mentioned in the video so far. So guys, there's a lot more going on behind the scenes of Star Citizen than just Star Citizen. And yeah, today I'm going to prove that. So anyway, let's just get straight to the crux of it. So for the first quite a few years, there were 7 years, we had the original Reddit refund guys. You know, they came in from the start, they tried to help people get refunds, probably helped people try to, you know, get out and write all the right stuff and all the things they needed to CIG in a scripted manner in which the CIG would then respond positively and go, yes, all right, we'll give you your refund for your entire purchase. And it is a purchase, it's not a pledge. You're purchasing ships, you're purchasing an asset, it was a JPEG, it's still an asset, it's still something, you're purchasing something, you're exchanging money for something, it's a purchase, it's not a pledge. A pledge is of a promise of financial gain, or a promise of something, but with no actual tangible outcome or, you know, ownership of anything, including a JPEG. So, guys, we have been purchasing ships from the start. The pledges stopped at the end of Kickstarter, and that was just for, that was money pledges. It wasn't actually for a tangible asset. Now it is. We are purchasing products, and that you are asking for a refund for, as you are not able to use them under consumer law anywhere in the world. Basically says if you can't use it or it's broken or damaged, well, you get your money back. That's just how shit works. So these guys in the Refund Reddit have been fighting for years and years and years, and they're a really, really good group of people. The mods were really nice people too, and they saw the value in a laugh, especially of my videos of past, especially. And yeah, and they saw the satire, and they saw the value of it, and how it, you know, would really kind of push the point across to people to say, well, hey, yeah, there is an issue, and this guy is making light of it and fun of it, so good for him. Until, I'd say about 18 months ago, they started to kind of, the Reddit kind of started to go on autopilot, and I'm sure if anyone's actually been in that Reddit posting things, they have noticed that, and all of a sudden, this new group of kids took over. Well, what we thought were kids. So, through my investigations and, you know, me putting videos up and putting these little brats in their place, the ones that I've already pre-mentioned, plus move speed, I forgot to add you, sorry, kid. There you go. There's your 15 seconds of fame, princess. As long with, and Heavy Bob, right? Geez, you're all pathetic. So anyway, and Dylan Phoenix and all the usual morons like Leo Grandius and psycho shit monkeys you got, guys all are, you little skitsian motherfuckers. So, about 12 months ago, in a nutshell, these guys took over the Refund Reddit. The other guys basically relinquished it and quit doing the Reddit forum, because it can be and is a full-time job if you make it so. And there is a lot of stuff you've got to deal with on the daily. So, and killing people with contradictory evidence. Dun, dun, dun. People actually have a controversial opinion. Dun, dun, dun. So anyway, these kids took over, these people, some humans, took over, Agony Aunt, Kersey, what his name is, and Beatwagon, as well as Cats of Fuzzy, I think, from the moderation team side of things, and a couple other henchmen who hang around, like WDM, or WMD, what it is. I know I put their names up, can't be bothered to remember them, because they're just so not worth my time. So all of these guys from Elite Dangerous, not one of them has purchased a Star Citizen product of any kind. But they're running a Star Citizen Refund Reddit channel. Ah! That makes sense, doesn't it, ladies and gentlemen? No, it doesn't. You know why? Because I have since found out that these people are running a undermarket scam. So people that are really desperate to get out of SC, and there's a lot of people at the moment, guys, all of you shills going, oh no, look, the numbers are growing, and you've already seen 510k. Now you need to look at those numbers and realize they're just now dead accounts with no ships in them. You know who got the ships? Have one guess. Yeah, the whales. So what's happening is these guys are getting in and they are conning people. Oh, your ship's only worth a quarter of the price. Right, and I've already shown you the grey market posts and stuff like that in the videos, so you know what I'm talking about. And your ship's worth a quarter of the price, and the grey market's dead, and there's no way, anyway, other way, especially not eBay or Amazon, are you going to be able to sell your ships. This is the only way left for you, and unfortunately, because the value of the market valuation of your ship has gone down so heavily, I'm willing to pay above the understated market price for you, to help you get out, because I appreciate, I should be doing a Russian accent, I appreciate that, you know, you're having such a tough time and you've decided to leave the project, which is a real pity, but I'm here to help you out of the situation. So then these guys buy these ships for next to nothing. These poor people who, let's say someone's putting $4,000, nice round, even number. They're getting about $1,800 back out of their $4,000. And that's no joke, guys. I'm not kidding. So these guys are then picking up all these ships, right? And whatever they are, $4,000 worth of ships, $1,800. And then guess what? The only people that get them, only people that they send them forward to, is the whales. And then the whales buy them up for less than real market value. I do this because there's no real value on those ships. They're just fucking JPEGs. And still buy them for a profit compared to online market. They're just paying just under the market for retail, right? These Russian scammers from Elite Dangerous, and then pocketing that money and fraudulently acting as a broker. Now, if these guys aren't licensed and all this shit blows up later, which it's going to, we know this, well, these guys themselves aren't going to be indicted as such. They're pulling the perfect scam in that respect. They cannot be legally charged as they are offering a gift service, or, you know, they'll use some fantastical technology because the Russian and Russian people are very, very rippy off. That's more Italian, but anyway, right? The Russians will just run and hide. They're a communist country. No one in Russia is going to bring them to the law, right? And they're going to run off with all this extra money that they have ill-got, and you poor bastards that have sold your ships to them and got completely ripped off on your way out are going to be the ones that might actually have the terms of service of agreement and user license agreement and privacy agreement actually come back on you, especially at a federal court case in America. So guys, if you have sold out in this manner, I would highly recommend, doing some research on this, because I think you might have gone and fucked yourselves. And if I'd have known about this earlier, obviously, guys, I would have reported this a very long time ago, but unfortunately I didn't. So guys, I'm giving you the heads up now. These guys are scammers. They are all Elite Dangerous players. Not one of them is a Star Citizen player. They are using, like, as the mob does, you know, the Russian mob, you know, they're using that web page as a front end. They're using Beatwagon in the FTR channel to pick up poor squabs who want to get out desperately. And, you know, that's where a lot of people who want to get out of Star Citizen go to. They go to FTR's channel. No, nothing personal, FTR, mate. I love your work. Love you, brother. But at the end of the day, bro, like, you've got these little fucking loser lurkers hanging around your Discord, and it's not good juju, mate. It's bad news, because they are getting people from your Discord and getting them to get ripped off. So, yeah, your mate Beatwagon isn't really your mate. He never was. And I called him out recently, and, well, you saw the comments he put up in your Discord in a conversation with me. So, guys, look, I've kind of pulled the rabbit out of the hat here. The whole big thing is, guys, is this is legitimate. It is true. The evidence is there. End of the day, guys, these guys are literally ripping you off. They're funneling those ships back to the whales, which means technically 510K accounts is probably down to about 350,000 accounts by now. And this is, you know, this has been for 12 months. That they've been doing this. So a lot of people have been going through these channels. This guy, this Kersey, or whatever his name is, he's actually actively setting up posts in Spectrum, okay? And that's what it is. That's the big scary thing. He's actually getting into Spectrum, so he's using someone's account to access Spectrum to put it under, you know, his name, to actually put up these posts to say, oh yeah, look, the grey market's down, come, sell your ships for us. You know, there's no other way you're going to be able to sell them. You know, the arse has fallen out of the market, just like I've showed you in the video so far. If you want all the rest of the information, tell me, and I'll put it all in a big, massive, bloody portfolio in a Google Doc for you. I'll make it available to the public, and you can read through every single thing that has been provided to me. So, the person, obviously, that has provided that information will not be disclosed, but the information itself will be wholeheartedly upon request. I have no interest in holding anything back about this. If the whales now are having a very lopsided ownership of ships and assets in the game, so assets including Hangar Flare, then do you understand what's going to happen, guys? Is there's going to be 10 people, maybe 15, who own 80% of everything, and guess what we get to buy? Auroras and Mustangs. That's it. So, guys, you need to start thinking about this. If these whales do this, and they own 80% of the ships in the game between them, when it comes to compo, not if, when it comes to the federal court case and the compo side comes in, compensation, if you didn't get the Australian terminology, right, who's going to benefit most? Us little tiny little sardines, or the big whales who ate us up for breakfast? Especially if there's a commission on the compensation that we'll be receiving. They will be able to double their profits. Keep in mind, guys, the whales are rich people. They are business people for the most part, and some of them are very sport-rich inheritance kids, right? At the end of the day, there's someone advising them saying, yes, this is like the stock market. Buy this, buy this, buy this. Hold on to it. Wait for the crash and sell out just afterwards when everyone is going to be going to court. There's compensation, class actions, all this stuff going on. There's a lot of talk about that over the last 18 months, 2 years. Not just from me. I wasn't even talking about this back then. But the Refunds Reddit was strongly, staunchly opposed to no refunds. And they were fighting and fighting and fighting to the point where they gave up, and these guys went, oh, yes, let's do this, let's do this. I'm from Russian mob, yes, I shall do this. I shall take their money. And I'll give them a little bit back. Very Russian-esque attitude, very mobster attitude, very sociopathic, dark, and evil intent. At no stage do they have you or me interested in mind. They have this and only this. We're in an impasse with Star Citizen, and we've got nowhere further to go. There's nothing happening. 3.11. And let me quote our very good friend, Salty Mike. It's boring. Nothing's happening. Nothing's changed. Why are we on 3. Anything anyway still? I thought 3.10 was the end of it. We're going to end up having 3.100 at this stage. Guys, it's done with. They had Squadron 42 ready in March, and the investors fucked that for us. And Chris's comment recently, with Squadron 42 specifically, I will not be bullied into blah, blah, blah. I will make the game that I always visioned, and that is going to be it. Tough. Well, guess what, Chris? When you go to jail, the game you're going to be playing is Don't Drop the Soap. And I guarantee you, mate, with a pretty little boy bitch face like that, you're going to get loved by the boys in jail. Because, mate, you're scum. You are absolute garbage as a human being. You've gone from being good old Chrissy now to being just, you're garbage, mate. You're still saying you're part of the SC project. You know you're not. We know you're not, but you're pretending by putting a letter from the chairman up. How's that going for you, Tony? These guys are scamming on that Reddit. Come to our Reddit. At least they, you're not going to be harassed, bullied, made fun of, memed, you know, circle jerked, or, you know, enter the society of the Reddit boy-loving faction. With strawberries between your toes. Bondage toys, and the demons themselves. But yeah, guys, look, Halloween's coming up. Just be safe, have fun, enjoy Halloween, don't eat too much chocolate and sugary stuff, and just make sure that you take, solace in that it's another year, you're alive and I'm alive. That we're not going to be able to escape these gnats from our society. But what we can do is when we catch them in the act of breaking the law and conning people, good or bad, doesn't matter who it is, still conning people out of their hard-earned money or ill-gained monies, you know, for a massive profit for themselves, when they don't even participate in the goddamn project that we're in, they're the opposing faction. You know, in your Warcraft bloody situation, they're the orcs and we're the humans. And why to God are we doing business with the enemy? So guys, look, if I were you, I would highly, highly recommend that you just stop posting anything there. It might come back on you in future as well. It might come back on me too, because obviously I've posted things there. It's not about shadow banning or any of that gaslighting bullshit. It's about you're giving these guys a reason or an opportunity to operate a front, a business front as such, to then facilitate these Discord back ends to come back in to talk to this Kersey guy to then have these other watchdogs, you know, henchmen, and Cat's a Fuzzy guy, making money off people in the community and sifting that money through to the wrong people we don't want it to go to. It's up to you guys. You want Star Citizen to survive. You want Star Citizen to become a success. Well, one, we have to kick the developers' ass. Two, you got to stop this immediately. And you got to call these things out, as we've seen, into the mind of how they think today, visually, that they're never going to change. They're never going to stop unless we take the affirmative action to stop them. At the end of the day, guys, this is our project. This is our game. They've got their game, right? And I have nothing against Elite Dangerous as a game or as a community. But these people, these subhumans, these things, these beasts are trying to ruin it for us for their own personal financial gain. And just because they're so fucking insane for the benefit of a badge or a pip on their shoulder, say, oh, I took Star Citizen down. Ha, 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 ha. I mean, it's looking a little dangerous. It's the only game left in the game universe. Guys, stop letting them do it. Because fuck me. Star Citizen is already enough trouble. You want to have your hard-earned money stolen from you by being conned out of it? And trust me. These guys are master manipulators. I'm sure they've written a very, very concise script in which to fuck you over with. I've spoken to people who have come to me since this initial report and said, oh, look, they are so, so convincing. And they make you feel like you are making the right decision. And, you know, this is the best possible thing because you're never going to get more money than this back. If anything, you're not going to get anything back. Honestly, these guys are professionals at what they do. And unfortunately, they are using spin selling practices from Neil Rackham as part of their process. And as I said to you, spin selling in the wrong hands, guess what? People are getting conned out of their ships, out of their money, out of their investment, and then they are shifting that investment back onto the whales who don't need it and probably have 15 Auroras and 62 bloody Mustangs and whatever else. Right, three bloody javelins. Shit, one of them might even have a Bengal carrier already because they suck Chris's cock. But that's the thing, guys. It is becoming a true like an antique car dealer show kind of thing where it's all about bragging rights. I have 365,000 ships. And you've only got 364,999. I'm winning, but they're all Auroras. I don't care. It's still the numbers game because we're whales. I've already got my capital fleet times two. That's what's going on with the whales, guys. This is why they kicked up recently too in the previous video, which I'll also relink in the description below for you. Okay, end of the day, guys, the whales are treating this as a collector's item, kind of the Star Wars-y kind of thing, where they're the only ones that have the investment in it. Things go ass up, which they're going to. They know they're going to now because they're having advisors tell them it's going to then be able to profit off the commission of the compensation that they're going to get anyway, along with the rest of us in much, 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 much tiny increments than they are. Those of you that have sold out to these morons, these scumbags, these criminals, these fraudsters, these con men on the Star Citizen subreddit or behind the doors of, and if you've spoken to Beatwagon and he's helped facilitate that for you, please put it in my comments. We're going to try to get together a portfolio to just keep for prosperity's sake. So if the time does come, we've got all the information we need from this event as well to further implicate whoever was involved to see if we can get some criminal action taken against them as well. So guys, look, I want you just to watch this last part of the video. I really appreciate you stuck around till now. I hope you've enjoyed, the Halloween special side. As well as the serious side. This is a message to all of my subscribers and anybody who's thinking about subscribing to my channel or anybody that hates my guts. And please pass the word around to other people who are going to watch this video that this last bit of this video is it. This is me, and it's not about me and my channel. It's about what I've started and what I am finishing without anybody trying to get in the way, because it's not happening. Anyway, I hope you enjoy this last part of the video. Thanks, guys.
Life is a war. And there are people out there and there are things out there that are trying to take you down. Things are going to go wrong. And when things go wrong, it's pretty easy just to say, you know what, I'm going to stand down or I'm going to give up. And you can do that. But I think no. I think no. I think keep fighting. And you keep fighting and you keep fighting and you keep fighting no matter what. And you never quit. You never, never quit. And if you feel like your life is in a place where you can't get any lower, and you don't think you can find any way out, good. Because that means the ultimate challenge is ahead of you. It means you can only go up. And it also means that things are going to be tough. Things are going to be tougher than anything you can imagine. But that storm that you're in, from your perspective, it seems like that storm is enveloping the whole world. But I'm telling you, it is not. The storm that you're in, it is hard to see out of that storm. It's hard to see past it. It seems like the storm is everything. But the storm is not everything. And it won't last forever. You can get out of the storm, and you will get out of the storm. And when you get out, you're gonna see the sun again. But right now, you're being tried. You're being forged. You're being tested by fire and by pain. That's the test. Don't fail the test. Don't fail the test. Don't give in. Don't quit. Don't ever quit. Fight on. Fight through the storm. Fight through the pain and come out the other side stronger and tougher and better. A fighter. A survivor. A winner. Victorious. And free from that storm. Free from the darkness. Free. Life can be hard. But you know what? It's the one life you've got. So go and live a life that in the end allows you to look back and say, hell yes, I do it all again.
All right, guys, look, all I can say is thank you so much for watching through to the end of the video. Please click, like, subscribe, bell, do all the cool stuff. We want to grow. I want this channel to grow for everyone's benefit, not just for me by any means. I want to get this message out there. I want to start finding new ways of helping people other than Star Citizen as well. The Cyberpunk 2077 conversation I am going to be gingerly starting on in the next couple of videos. I want to kind of move away from SC, the dumpster fire it is, the fire festival it is, and start talking about Cyberpunk. So I think that's something that's going to demonstrate how this was just the litmus test, the tiny little petri dish of social, just whatever it is, right, discourse to a point of pure insanity. This is this big. If Cyberpunk 2077 goes full political and full SJW and feministy and culty and fucking nah, asexual shit, the volume of garbage is going to be this high compared to this. So this would have been, in my eyes, as I speak right now to you, the proving ground for what's coming next. And what's coming next is going to be worse than anything any of you have ever experienced in a game community environment, social situation. More importantly, once the multiplayer asset comes in for Cyberpunk 2077, even though it's not going to, bullshit, as well as the map got shrunk like a chunk. So with multiplayer, you're just going to literally be on top of each other in a battle royale, basically. I don't see the value proposition for Cyberpunk 2077 at this stage. I don't see the value proposition of all the hype and all the marketing and all the bullshit and the feminist crap and the SJW crap and the asexual crap and people not liking this, people liking that, people not realizing it's the, you know, way ahead in the future, 2077, where obviously society's gone to shit already. Obviously, we're already heading down that pathway, guys, if you haven't already noticed. G'day, Trump. Drink some bleach. Just saying. All right, now government. Holy shit. We are run by a literal criminal syndicate here in Australia. So get me started on that. Guys, look. Enjoy other games. Enjoy other things. Because Star Citizen, if it is ever going to surface and ever going to become the thing we've always wanted it to be, it's a very, very long way off. Let's just shelf Star Citizen for now. Let's table Cyberpunk 2077. There's going to be a lot to talk about, a lot of complaints, a lot of shortcomings, and a lot of things that were overpromised and once again underdelivered. So guys, as per usual, and as per always, happy Halloween and peace out. Cheers.